What's up, guys? Welcome back to the Terrier Owner YouTube channel. Josh here with terrieroner.com, the channel specifically designed for new terrier owners to get the information they need to take care of their new terriers in an easier fashion. So if you need that kind of help, be sure to subscribe to the channel. Otherwise, I want to jump into 8 pros and cons of owning and raising a Jack Russell Terrier, and we're starting right now. All right, guys, that's right. I was able to come up with 8 specific pros and cons about owning one of these Jack Russell Terriers right here. So I'm going to give you 8 of the good things and 8 of the bad things. But naturally, I wanted to start it off with the good things. So let's start with the 8 pros of adopting and raising a Jack Russell Terrier, and then we'll move into the cons. Sound good? Sounds good to us. Let's get things kickstarted. And guys, make sure you stick around for those 8 cons, or make it to the end of the video, because we will give you some caveats to those cons and how you can turn them around in case you have already adopted your Jack Russell. So that should benefit you greatly. So again, make sure you stick around and let's dive into the first pro, which for me, pro number 1 is these dogs, Jack Russell Terriers, are extremely smart. Getting the intelligence out of a dog breed right off the bat is obviously a pro, because it can benefit you in several ways. A, it makes training a lot easier. Sometimes. Depends on what kind of training we're talking about here. Let's word it like this. It makes training a lot easier if you put in the time to work with them. They are eager to learn, they want to learn, but they can also be very stubborn, which we'll talk about that more later when we go into the cons. But keep that in mind. Extremely smart, but they still need you to do your end of the deal in order for that intelligence to actually show. But nonetheless, getting a smart dog, or a dog as smart as a Jack Russell right out of the gates, is a pro, if you ask me. No, face licking is not one of the pros on the list. Something kind of affectionate, maybe? All right, guys, pro number 2 is this is one of the most loyal dog breeds you're ever going to be able to adopt. It may be the most loyal dog breed in general. She, my God. I mean, if you're the owner and you're the one that this dog attaches to in the household, they are going to be at your ankles everywhere you go, never want to leave your side, even on days that you don't feel like putting up with them or dealing with them, they're still going to be right there. By far, one of the most affectionate dogs you can adopt. On the flip side, which again, we'll talk about that when we get to the cons, it can be a little annoying at times, but again, we'll talk about what you can do about it. But when it comes to loyalty, it doesn't get any better than this dog right here. Number 3, guys, or one of the things I love about owning a Jack Russell, or what I would consider a pro, is the size of the dog. I have a big dog that's about 90 pounds, a yellow lab. He is a beast. Nothing against big dogs. I've always loved big dogs, but now that I've owned what I would call a pocket pet, not quite a pocket pet, but now that I've owned a small dog, the size is kind of nice. You can pick them up, interact with them. Any accessories are typically cheaper. It costs less to feed them. Much better at cuddling and being a lab dog than obviously a big dog. Even though the big dog thinks he's a lap dog still, but from all of those angles, having a small dog can be a big benefit. All right, guys, number 4 is this dog, if you want it to, and it should happen, is they can keep you fit and active. They need exercise, they desire it, they want it, and it helps them behave better overall. Doesn't matter what you want to do with them, especially if they're full grown. The activities are kind of limitless at that point when it's not going to put the impact on these bones or any of the joints. You could do running, walking, cycling, rollerblading, fetch, whatever you want to do, they're going to be capable of it. They're going to enjoy it, and it's going to help them and obviously us, especially in a day and age where we sit more than we've probably ever sat in our life. But nonetheless, a dog that's capable and craves that kind of exercise, I find it as a positive, so we will put that in the win column for the Jack Russell. All right, guys, number 5. This one kind of ties back into number 1 with the loyalty, but extremely affectionate dogs. As you can see, they love their families and they love their owners. Yes, they can be a little bit more on the nippy or aggressive side with the same sex of other dogs. There are things that you have to do to work with them in that respect, but when it comes to their family, their caretakers, or their owners, They are as affectionate as they come. If I were to be sitting on the couch the entire day, which probably happens way more than it should, she would be willing to sit there all day. Like, as long as that's where I am or somebody else in the family is, that's where she will want to be. That's how she behaves. I don't know if that's every Jack Russell ever. I'm sure some of them are more independent, but I'm assuming that as a breed in general, that these dogs are highly affectionate and take a strong liking to their owners. I have no idea what she's doing right now or... The next one, guys, and another one that I love about this dog is they're relatively cheap to adopt. If you get a full bred like Luna here is, it can run you up to about $1,000. We got a lot of kind of little extras with our adoption from our breeder, but $1,000 in 2020 is not a lot to adopt a dog. There are dogs that far exceed that price tag. And once you own them and you're raising them, the ongoing costs are kind of minimal compared to some other dogs too, because they're smaller, which means less recurring cost on things like monthly food. Typically smaller dogs, unless they have a ton of health problems, will cost less each time they go to the vet, depending on what's going on. But overall, the cost to adopt one, plus what you're getting, I would find is a major positive about a Jack Russell. Which leads me right into number 7, is if you're gonna spend the money, if you're gonna work with a dog that can be so high strung and stubborn, even though I've already mentioned all the positives that come with that, why not have the work pay off in a fashion that you get 13 to 17 years of lifespan out of one of these dogs? I'm not saying anything against dogs that have a shorter lifespan, and most small dogs do have long lifespans, don't get me wrong, but, you know, for a small dog, if you're gonna... Jeez, put your ear down. For a small dog with relatively low amount of health problems, 13 to 17 years in my book, is another positive about adopting one of the Jack Russells. And then my last pro before we move into the negatives or the cons is tying back into how smart they are, but with training, discipline, and consistency, these dogs are highly capable of learning what you want to teach them. They listen intently. They want to go through that movement of training with you. So if you're looking for a dog that you need to put in the work with but can benefit greatly from that training, this is a dog for you. It depends what you're trying to do. There's some things I haven't done. You know, I haven't taught her to be a hunting dog or anything like that, although I can imagine she would be really good at it. If you haven't seen my video about these guys with mice and rats, be sure to check that out on the channel playlist before you leave. I'll also link it in the description below, but that'll give you a better idea of what I'm talking about. But overall, again, if you want to put in the work, they're right there with you. They're willing to do it and highly trainable. If you don't, then you probably, it has nothing to do with the Jack Russell at that point. You just don't need to adopt any kind of dog. Now, guys, let's dive into the negatives. I know I don't really feel like going through them either, but it only seems fair to mention all of the ridiculous things these dogs do, which they do plenty of them, especially when they're young. So let's get those started. And again, make sure you stick around to the end so you kind of get an idea of what you can do about each of these cons in order to counter or offset some of those negatives and turn them into a positive. All right, guys, so con number one is this dog is an escape artist. If there's a dog that knows how to get out of the yard, you're looking at it. Some of that is due to their natural prey drive, since they were bred initially for hunting. Some of it could be because they're not neutered or spayed. If you guys need to read about how that can help you, I will link those videos in the description below. But nonetheless, they know how to get out of a yard. So my recommendation is to make sure that you proof the yard, make sure there's no gaps or areas they can go over or under a fence or, you know, wedge between it, because they will dig, they can jump very high, and they will find a way. So proof your yard in advance, and then you don't have to worry about it. And again, spaying and neutering can help as well, so keep that in mind. Number two, guys, you're looking at an expert digger right here. Like, if you need some things dug in the yard, like intentionally, just leave them alone for a few hours when they're young. I would also have a few bags of topsoil always on hand. Literally always. Guys, they dig. They pick up scents from animals. They're diggers. If they get bored, they dig. So your best way to counter this is A, if they're outside, check in on them every now and then, see what they're doing. B, if there's a way to keep other rodents and other animals out of the yard, do so. And C, just expect that it's going to happen. I would be shocked if you have a fenced-in backyard and you leave them out there for any duration of the time during the day, and you make it through an entire puppyhood into adulthood with a Jack Russell without at least one hole dug. They will do it. Work with them, train them, and then again, do those things I just mentioned in order to start reducing the amount of digging that they do. All right, guys, number three is, it's kind of true, but it's also kind of a myth about these dogs. They do absolutely get along with other dogs, but there has been times where, like when she was in her first heat, that she was a little bit more aggressive towards our bigger dog. She never hurt him or bit him, but you can tell when they're in a mood, and especially with dogs of the same sex, they are not always known to be the friendliest dog. So make sure that if you want to bring a Jack Russell into the home that is of the same sex as another dog, that you start the socialization process like immediately so that they can get used to each other and grow that relationship, and then you shouldn't have any issues. But trying to do it later could cause problems, so keep that in mind as well. All right, guys, con number five is kind of plays back into one of the positives. For some people, the energy of this dog can be overwhelming. When you don't get them out, whenever they have no outlet to burn off energy, they can be a wild child, to put it nicely. I mean, sprinting circles around the house, wanting to play with everybody, chasing the other dog around, it happens. So if you don't like to provide any kind of outlet for them to burn that energy, either be happy with the fact that they're going to have that high amount of energy left all day, or understand that it's going to happen and find a way to counter that. Because trust me, if you don't, they will have that energy at the end of the day. They do not calm down without you putting in some kind of routine into place in order for them to burn that energy off. And the next one, guys, is one that I just did a video about. The previous video, which I will also link in the description below, was all about these dogs following you everywhere. Yes, I get that it's part of the loyalty positive that I had already mentioned, but it also plays into a con, because separation anxiety with this dog is a real thing. They do not like to be away from the family or the owner. They whine, especially when they're young, so you have to push through that crate training. You have to make them understand that life goes on without you. Otherwise, they're just a whiny, barking dog whenever you're not around. But separation anxiety is 100% real, and it impacts this dog for sure, or at least that's been my experience so far. And the last con of the day, guys, and one to keep in mind, and plenty of things that you can do about it, is this dog, or the Jack Russell Terrier, does not do well with boredom. When they are bored is when they find bad things to do. So you need toys. You need to keep them from getting bored. If you're going to leave them alone and they're going to get bored, you need the crate, or you need a proofed area of the house behind a gate that they can't jump. Because if you don't, I assure you, they will find something that you don't want them to find, and they will do something to it. Won't you? They don't do well with boredom, period. So guys, 8 pros, 8 cons. What do you think? Do you own a Jack Russell Terrier currently? Leave us some comments and let us know what you think of those 8 pros and the cons. Agree, disagree, feel free to leave us those comments. If you guys like this kind of content, again, guys, be sure to subscribe to the channel so that you are able to catch both videos every week. She is now rolled over under her belly. And a little bit of an update, Thursday's videos are now going to start being moved to Sunday. So from now on, it'll be Tuesdays and Sundays for the 2 videos per week. Guys, give us a thumbs up if you like this kind of content. Those thumbs up help us tons more than you think. It helps YouTube's algorithm push these videos out to others with Jack Russell Terriers so that they can get this helpful advice. Again, subscribe, leave us a comment, hit that notification button so you are notified when the new videos come out. And same thing goes for visitingterrieroner.com. Even if you don't want to read the blogs, head over to the website just by typing in terrieroner.com into your URL. That also helps that website get shown more to other people with Jack Russell Terriers. Plenty of useful blogs on there for you to check out. Otherwise, guys, we're going to catch you guys on Sunday for the first Sunday video of our new scheduling routine going forward. We appreciate you stopping by. Thanks again, and take care.